My design is based off of the revolutionary Gadsden flag that was made in the late 1700s for the American Revolution. It was a symbol for civil liberty. Since I was a little kid, I've always loved drawing, but as I got older, I turned that interest in art into graphic design, photography, print work. Another thing that I was absolutely in love with was biking. And I would say biking is more of a creative inlet for me. I use it to clear my mind and gain inspiration by just going for long rides. Sometimes the chaos of commuting downtown on my bike gets me a little jazzed, and I'll get excited and work through ideas in my mind. Yeah, on my commute, the landscape changes in that 25 miles significantly. You kind of realize that we're all in the city together, we're all in this urban area together, and we're not that far apart from each other. Yeah, when I was heading down to the protest, I was on my bike and ended up getting up front and leading the protest through intersections, and each intersection was blocked off by police officers. And I knew that through my time in the military, I knew how to talk to authority figures. I knew how they needed to be, the information needed to be told quickly and what needed to happen, and be confident while you're talking to them. When the governor called out the National Guard, it would have been a time that I would have had it been called up, but now that I'm out of the military, I was able to find a different way to be involved. And that way was me being in the protest, taking photos, getting inspired, listening to stories, and taking that and going back home and creating this design. And knowing what people were feeling and being able to talk to them and not be an authority figure for once in that type of situation allowed me to be able to make that artwork. When I got back from the protests, I just sat down for a half hour and drew this design out, threw it up on Reddit, not thinking much of it, and then went to bed. And then when I woke up, it had gone viral, and it was super insane. It was kind of fun to see this and hear stories from people. And after that, I connected with a black-owned print shop. We made t-shirts of the design, sold them, raised money for the NAACP. After that, people were starting to take my design and do things differently with it by changing where the snake's at or changing what the pose of the panther is, but the idea was still there and the message, "Don't kneel on me," was still there. And I saw it on protest signs, I saw it painted on the street, I saw it on murals. You know, a t-shirt is interesting. When someone paints it on the side of a wall, it's there every time you drive by it. You see it multiple times instead of just maybe once, one chance encounter with the t-shirt. So it's really interesting to see my artwork inspire people enough to permanently put it on the side of a wall. In the next 5 years, to see how this design would change the community, it would be interesting to hear more of the conversation on what people think about that design, what it might inspire people to do, or like, you know, if the "Don't Kneel on Me" message resonates with somebody, like, what are they going to go do in the next 5 years? Are they going to be a better activist? Are they going to call their senator? Are they going to, or to do anything? Having that message out there in the world eventually make some sort of difference to somebody or to a lot of people. My name is Chris Axelson, and I am involved.